Hi everyone, welcome to this week's Glow video. My name is Steph. It's great to be with you this week. We're finishing up our series on how to read the Bible, and we're talking about setting. Now, setting is about so much more than maybe what you do in English class. Maybe you think of reading literature, maybe you think of a film or TV set. What setting does is it helps us figure out what's going on. You know, sometimes we see different settings and we think, is it? It's okay.
So when you see different settings,
I'm sorry, I'm changing it up. Maybe this will be 30 minutes. No, I'm so sorry. I genuinely, I bullet point and then I just talk.
So English class, do you use that word?
Film and TV, how's that? Okay. Hi everyone, Steph here. Welcome to this week's Glow video. I'm really excited to be talking today about our last part of our How to Read the Bible series on setting. Now, when you think of setting, you might think of something maybe you do in English class where your teacher makes you look through the setting to figure out what the author is trying to say. Or maybe you think about TV and film, your favorite TV and film show. When that setting comes on, when you see that background, you think, I know where this is going. Maybe if you watch a lot of Law and Order, you see a courtroom and you know someone's about to get caught or someone's about to get away with it. Or maybe when you're watching a film, you see a dark, narrow forest or stairwell and you get really tense, start to cover your eyes because you know what's coming. Someone's around the corner. Or maybe like me, you watch a lot of superhero films, and so you see that grand battle scene, and you get excited because you think, I know what's about to happen. They're about to save the day. Setting helps us figure out where the story is going to go. And we can't help but fill it in with our own expectations and assumption and to make up our mind and say, I know where this is going. We have a wonderful example of setting throughout Scripture. Setting that we see not only in the Old Testament, but in the New Testament. Because the incredible thing about setting in the Bible is that we have the same settings, the same places, the same time frames, the same situations from the Old Testament in the New Testament. And when we read the Bible, we see these settings get turned on their head. A big plot twist happens when Jesus comes on the scene. A few examples that we see of this in Scripture. You know, for example, with Egypt. In the Old Testament, Egypt is a negative place for God's people. They're enslaved there for a very long time. So we see them exit Egypt, and God promises them, you'll never have to go back again. But then when the Israelites are running from God and his calling on their lives, they return to Egypt, and there they find abuse and hardship. So Egypt has this negative connotation. But then we turn a few books later in the New Testament, and we see baby Jesus being rushed into Egypt when his family was being persecuted. And times you have 40 years. You have 40 years a lot through the Scriptures of the Old Testament. 40 years of wandering in the desert for the Israelites. And then in the New Testament, you have Jesus going after his baptism into the desert for 40 days. And in that, we find hope and freedom for ourselves. You also see situations. There's a lot in the Old Testament about exile and laws that tell us that in certain situations, people were outcasts, that they were seen as less than. And then in those same situations, Jesus faces them in the New Testament. But instead of banishing people and cutting them off, he reaches out a hand. He shows them love. This is important to us, firstly, because it makes Scripture interesting to read. It gives us new things to find. We can read the Old Testament, which sometimes can feel really distant from us. A lot of names and numbers we don't understand, dimensions of a temple we're never going to build. And we read that and we disconnect with it. But actually, if we read it side by side with the New Testament, we see things, mentions of places and people, and it makes things go off in our brain and we realize, oh, that's mentioned again. The other way that this is important for us, and what I really want for you to get out of this, is that in retelling these stories and resetting in Scripture all of these stories, what Jesus is offering us is a resetting of our own stories. He'll take our places, the times we've been through, our situations that feel so familiar that we think we already know how the story is going to be told, and he tells a new story. So I want to encourage you. I'm going to put some scriptures down below in the description. from Old Testament and New Testament, and I want you to read them side by side. Hear the story in a new way to see the connections and to spend some time in prayer. When you find yourself in a setting and you think, I know how this is going to go, stop and pray. Ask Jesus to reset your setting and retell your story, to bring in new hope and life, because that's what he does. He brings in new things. He is the plot twist that all we need to do is ask for, and he can change everything. And if you haven't discovered that newness and hope with Jesus before, can I encourage you, all it takes is just starting a relationship with him, saying, Jesus, I want that. I want what you are offering. And we would love to talk that through with you. So there's an email down below as well. Shoot us a message. We would love to chat with you and about what that means. So that's it. Before we go, I have another piece of news about a changing of setting. We're going to have Glow look a little different in the coming weeks. So make sure you keep an eye peeled, nudge your parents so they know to check their emails. We're hoping to be moving onto Zoom so we can have more of a conversation and discussion about the topics that we're looking at, about the Bible studies we do. So keep your eyes out for that. We're really excited for that change of setting, and we look forward to doing that with you.